"Whereabouts is this place where he lives?" asked Truffler casually.
"You go down to the harbour, then walk along the shoreline to the right. The house is virtually on the beach. Painted white, needless to say, red-tiled roof."
Truffler nodded, taking in the information, and exchanged a covert look with Mrs. Pargeter. She knew exactly what he was thinking, so she was unsurprised when, after refusing a top-up drink and saying she'd like to take up the offer of touring the cat sanctuary, Truffler Mason said he wouldn't come with them. Picking up his raincoat, he announced that he fancied stretching his legs with a stroll down to the harbour.
Chapter 18. Mendy Fastairs led Mrs. Pargeter along the side of her perfect blue swimming pool, through the displays of ancient Greek statuary, towards the cat sanctuary. Over-elaborate wrought-iron gates were open at the front. As they passed, Mrs. Pargeter noticed a large chain and padlock hanging from one of them. Apparently the place needed tight security. The buildings which housed the Greek end of the Philippoussis operation were of the same high spec as the clinic in Leon C, but less welcoming. There was no reception area, no cosy office for the entertainment of visitors. But then, presumably, there were very few visitors to the facility. It was only at the English end that potential owners came to inspect the goods on offer. As a result, the complex of buildings looked more like a military institution than anything else. The individual units were brick-built, but all had metal doors which could be closed with latches and padlocks. The behaviour of the sanctuary's inmates was also markedly different than those in Leon C. The Greek cats that had been given the sanctuary by Mendy Fastairs were distinctly ungrateful for her magnanimous gesture. They had enjoyed their semi-feral life around Atmos Harbour, basking in the shade beneath parked cars, darting out and weaving around the wooden legs of rush-seated taverna chairs, scavenging the food dropped either accidentally or deliberately by tourists, wolfing down the guts and entrails left by the fishermen on the harbour walls. They had relished the nights of caterwauling and fierce, quick, casual sex. Incarceration in cages, of however high a spec, was far from being their idea of fun. So the noise of feline complaint, which grew in volume as Mendy Fastairs and Mrs. Pargeter approached the sanctuary, was fairly overpowering. So was the smile and bolted-on charm of Costas Philippoussis. His lips, beneath the obligatory dark moustache, were thin, and the brown eyes flickered with cunning. He was all over Mrs. Pargeter.